Good day. Welcome to another edition of Spotlight on Mayor Pack Schools. Eric Rose, your host, along with Superintendent of Schools Anthony DiCarlo, without the mask.
Yes, finally, without the mask. We've come a long way, and it's, it's great to be able to see your face when we're talking. We still have the protocols, though, with the schools and masking based on the New York State, guidance and DOH. We have to follow that. But, as far as the kids go, but we're getting there, and we're hopefully optimistic that come next September, we'll be back to what the old normal used to be. But we'll see how that goes.
We're here at Mayor Pack High School today, and we're going to take a tour of the high school, explain in just a moment. But before we do, you want to thank residents of the Mayor Pack School District for coming out earlier in the month of May and approving a fiscal spending plan.
Yeah, on May 18th, I want to thank the community for their continued confidence in the work that we're doing. We continue to follow our strategic roadmap to bring the school district to the next level of excellence. We get to continue the programs that we've started, to even do some enhancing, and we know it's so important that we get our students caught up because of the pandemic over the last year and a half, that we have a lot more social emotional readiness for kids and what that looks like, and not just for our kids, but our entire staff. So I want to thank the community for all your continued support throughout the year. And of course, with this budget, it wasn't an easy year. And what makes Mayor Pack such a great place is the people's continued support for the work that we're doing.
And as we said, we're here at Mayor Pack High. We're going to be taking a tour of the building today and the fields to show you the before or the current and what's going to happen in the future.
Yes, we're really excited about it. And it's happening now. Actually, as we're speaking, we're doing some work inside what we call second shifts that you don't even see is going on at night or on the weekends. And then we're beginning to work on our turf field and starting to get that ready to go.
Mayor Pack High is going to be closed this summer.
Yeah, basically from the end of June after graduation through August, there's going to be close to $13 million worth of work done here. A lot of extensive renovations, and because of health and safety reasons, the building will be closed down. We'll be updating the public over the course of the summer and where we're at, as we get ready to open the school year. Understanding the work is going to continue into the fall. Again, a lot of second shift work and other things. As I've mentioned before at our board meetings, there may be some days where there's things that are happening that the water has to be shut or whatever, and we may have to wind up going to remote learning. But, parents will know about that along the way if we should have to do that.
And Mayor Pack High, one more quick question, graduation.
Yeah, we're set, to do graduation. It'll be, parents of the students will be invited. It'll be out in the turf field, and that'll be on Wednesday, June 23rd. That's the high school at 7 o'clock, and then the middle school moving up will be on Monday, June 21st at 6 o'clock.
Okay, let's take a walk around Mayor Pack High right here on Inside and Spotlight on Mayor Pack Schools. We're here in the Mayor Pack Library. Big changes are brewing.
Yeah, so this is one of the areas, Eric. This is going to become a library media center. As you can see right now, it's a traditional library. What's going to be happening is it's going to be all renovated. Of course, kids can come in and do research, but they can also come in. They're going to be specific little kind of pod areas that they can work individually on their Chromebooks or in groups. There'll be some small little rooms that they can work together. So we're really, really excited about bringing this space to the contemporary learning kind of environment it should be as a resource center for kids.
It's going to resemble a college library.
Yeah, it's going to be very bright. There's going to be great furniture for kids to be able to sit down. There are going to be stools to sit on and kind of like a bar-like atmosphere where they can sit with their Chromebook. There'll be places that you'll have couches and kind of chairs to sit, the traditional desks. There'll be some, what we call tables that are rounded so they can talk to one another and work together. It's going to be really where a library media center in 2021 should look like.
Not 1950-something.
No, and that's kind of the theme of this whole project, right? It's being able to create spaces that are contemporary for learning for our kids and, most importantly, our staffs to be able to teach it, and we're excited about it. And again, I want to thank the public. We're here. We're finally to that point, 2 years ago, a little bit over 2 years ago, we passed this bond. And of course, it takes time to get, approved and whatever. And the bodice of the work this summer is going to be here at Mayor Pack High School.
When should the library be completed?
Well, again, we're talking about, mid to late fall because of all the work that needs to be done. Again, patience. This takes time to be able to do. although a lot of the work will be done over the course of the summer months, we're also going to be working, like I said, second shifts through the fall.
Okay, next up.
Next stop, I think we are going to go probably most likely maybe to the renovation of the band area and the chorus area.
Let's check it out right here. We're here in the music room, and as you were saying off camera, the new music room has been designed by the musicians, by the faculty members who know what their kids need.
You know, and that is such a great point that you bring up, that we wanted to make sure with this bond is what we did that. There were extensive meetings here at the high school with the administrators, with each department, so they have a vested interest in it. We are creating learning environments that they know are best for kids. And that's what's so important. Like, for example, this room, you know, it was the traditional tiered. This is going to be all blown out. This is going to be all, you know, taken apart. We're going to go back to those back walls. It's going to be really what a music type of a quote-unquote studio rehearsal room should look like. And we're excited about that because we know in Mayapak we pride ourselves on having well-rounded students academically, extracurricular. And a lot of our kids, the extracurricular is clubs, music, sports, so many different things. And we're so proud of what we do here at Mayapak High School. And this is one of the areas that we made a commitment to, saying, listen, the arts are important in Mayapak, and we want to invest in them. And this is a perfect example in the bond of what we're doing with our music department.
Even cubbies, cubby holes right here. Maybe our cameraman, Sash, could swing his camera over there. Cubby holes, and Sash was telling us off camera that his cubby hole when he was in high school is still here.
Yeah, and you know what, you bring up such an important point, because a lot of times this happens, we're a K-12 district, and even though we have students right now that may be in the elementary school, and sometimes parents are like, well, it's not going to affect my child. It does. The work that we're doing now is going to impact your child through their journey when they get here. So that's really so important. And you bring up a great point. Again, over 30-something years. It's just, again, to the community, and I keep reiterating this, thank you. And it's so important to see the why behind the bond and what's going to wind up happening.
From music to STEM on our next tour. Outside the STEM suite here at Mayapak High, and as we say, it's going to be unbelievable. Moving walls, all kinds of new intricate patterns.
Yeah, so this whole wing and these rooms, 115, 113, and 112, are going to all be blown out, and there are going to be a variety of different learning areas for kids that can be, you know, moved around, whether it's the furniture, whether it's the walls. And we talk about career and college ready, and we know right now there is such a shortage of engineers, of that type of profession. And we have really embraced the program called Project Lead the Way, which is really an engineering and architectural type of a design framework and coursework. And we're proud of the work that we're doing. Computer sciences is another need. So this STEM, you know, area of learning, again, is so vitally important for our kids to be ready, to be competitive when they go into college, and ultimately college and career ready. So this is one of the areas we really prided ourselves on putting into this bond.
You talked about the bond. You thank the community out there. You want to also remind them there was no increase in taxes with this.
Yeah, so what winds up happening is that, you know, some of our debt from years ago comes off, and then what happens is you replace it. That's what you want to do, so you don't have where, you know, you're going out and spending $54 million and everybody's taxes is going up $200 or $300 a year. It's not, so we're excited about that. What we're also excited about, Eric, is the bond market is incredible. Mm. So we're getting really, really great, great interest rates on this work, which also was very, very helpful, because we continue to do that. And if, like on our first initial phase, we came in under budget. If you start to come in under budget, then some of those monies may be able to go to some other things that we can do towards the end. But again, you have change orders and other things that happen. But, you know, we're right now very optimistic on how things are proceeding and what's going on. However, we still have COVID, and what's happening in a lot of industries, there's a delay. You see what's happening with wood. You see what's happening with metal. So we have to understand these timelines may have to adjust based on stuff that we have no control over. And again, I really implore the public, especially those of you who have students here at the high school, you have to be patient come the beginning of the school year. And because there are going to be things that change from day to day, from week to week, we'll get through it. but we all have to be patient. It's just like in our homes. If we do work in our homes, there are going to be things sometimes that are torn up, and ultimately it's going to look beautiful, but we have to be patient with that. And that's where I need to the community to understand.
Let's continue our tour here at Mayapak High. The science wing here at Mayapak High is going to be getting a complete do-over. And any of you who have visited the science wing in recent years realize how antiquated it is.
Yeah, so if you remember 2.5 years ago, we were actually in this room, and I was just astonished that this was allowed to go on as long as it did. And again, to the credit of the science department, the science teachers, they've worked hard with our architects, and we're really going to design spaces, again, that are really cutting edge for not only the students, but for the teachers, ventilation, you know, the cabinetry, the furniture, the things that are important for them to have that are state of the art. Our kids should be in, especially in science, and we boast, which is incredible. Our kids do incredibly well in sciences and research projects and our EMT program. We are so blessed to the opportunities that we have here. Our kids and our teachers should be in those spaces that are commensurate with 2021 learning should look like. And this is an example of the, you know, before, and then we're going to show you some renditions of the after. And then as we go through the summer and you start to see the updates, we'll be updating you on Spotlight.
The scholarships, the awards, Mayapak High School science young men and women have received, off the charts.
Yeah, over the last number of years, and for many, many years. I mean, that's the quality of education that goes on within our science department, how our kids are so well-versed, and when they go out and do these research projects and they go into these competitions, how well we do. And it's one of the strengths here at Mayapak High School. And our kids and our staff should be in the best learning spaces. And again, I thank the community for allowing us to do this.
Okay, so we visited the library, we visited the science room. We're going to check it out in the next spot right here on Spotlight on Mayapak Schools. Well, Anthony, another area in need of dire repair, the locker rooms here at Mayapak High.
Yeah, the boys' locker room is definitely in repair. And we talk then about decades worth of you know, things not being adjusted or looked at. And we happen to be in the boys' locker room, and this is going to be another area that is renovated. Again, you know, better quality places for the boys to sit in regards to their lockers, to have some space where the coaches can meet and have conversations about strategy planning, whether it's halftime of a football game or halftime of a basketball game. So we're really excited about this area being renovated also, because again, we talk about well-roundedness, and you can see it affects everything: extracurricular, music, the arts, athletics, and I think it's definitely something that is needed.
It had been embarrassing, too, for Mayapak coaches, Mayapak families to have visiting teams come in and use these antiquated.
We talked about that. They've done a really good job with the girls' locker room. They were refurbished a number of years ago, probably about 4 or 5 years ago. We want to do the same thing for the boys' locker room, because you're correct. We want to have people to come into a spot that looks respectful and clean, and it is emblematic of who we are as a community. So, you know, a long time coming, and we're excited about it.
Now, I'm sure two parents are asking out there, what happens if the locker rooms are not completed by the time the new season begins?
Well, we do have some additional spaces, you know, that are adjacent to this that we can work in. We do have a weight room. If we had to do some of that, we could use it. Once again, you know, we want to be cautiously optimistic. You know, at some point in time for the full season, we'll be able to get in here and the students can use it as a part of their, getting ready, and then pregame and postgame.
Okay. The locker rooms, another item being updated and upgraded here at Mayapak High. A nice breeze is blowing outside of Mayapak High. Yeah. Feels good.
Yeah, it does. It's actually a little warm, but it's nice. There's a breeze. There's always a breeze up here at Mayapak High School because it's open. So in back of us, they've begun the work on our second turf field behind the stadium field. They took it over about a week ago. They're going to start to remove the dirt. Again, we are cautiously optimistic, Eric, that as they get this started to get done, we're hoping by the end of August, it'll come back to us and we can get our kids to be able to do their, you know, games and practices on here, you know, soccer, field hockey, football. We're really excited. But it's really important also, Eric, it's not just for the high school, it's for the community. So we've had conversations with MSA. After we're done during the week and on the weekends, MSA is going to be able to use it for football, for soccer. They have their you know, the airport field, but for lacrosse, they're going to be able to use this, which is great, and we're so excited about it. And this, again, I want to thank the community. This is a long time coming. You know, at one time, Mayapack High School was the pinnacle for sports, you know, facilities. We lost our way, and now we're trying to get back to where we should be.
You know, but it's so interesting, too. Timing is everything.
Yeah.
Just a year ago, the high school graduation took place on this field.
Correct.
And if it wasn't for that, it wouldn't have happened.
Correct. And hope this year we're lucky. We can go back onto the field and do graduation, like I said, on Wednesday, June 23rd. So we're excited about this. This is great. You know, it's interesting because the kids sometimes don't realize. So about a week ago, the lacrosse team, JV, was out here. And they said to Mr. Luciano, our AD, what's going on there? So he goes, this is going to be a turf field. You had to see their faces light up. So they don't realize it. Now they do. They're just excited about it because it's great for all of our sports. It's great for the community, and we're really excited about it.
You want to remind the residents out there, too, about the last week of school.
Yeah, so, you know, it's important. The last week of school, you know, there's a little bit of an adjustment. On the Monday and Tuesday, which is the 21st and 22nd, are going to be a half day for all of our grade 8 grade K to 8 students. High school gets out a little earlier because of Regents and whatever. Originally in the schedule we had Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, 23rd, 24th, and 25th. But in order for us to do these end of the year activities, to do the parades in the elementary school, we're going to be doing half days on that Monday and Tuesday in addition to the Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. And there's information going out today on my newsletter, and we'll be updating the public.
And of course, the high school graduation is the 23rd, middle school moving up day the 21st.
Right, and then you will be hearing from the building principals on those specific informations about parking, elementary school, what they're doing with their moving up ceremonies. All that information will be coming out in the next week.
Okay. Superintendent of Schools, Anthony DiCarlo, we thank you so much for joining us for this tour of the construction project here at Mayapack High. For Stash Przemilski, I'm Eric Gross. Until next time, be safe. Have yourselves a good one. Bye-bye now.
For more information, please visit our website, www.mayapack.org. More videos can also be found on our YouTube news channel, mcsd.news.